I don't think I came to preach. I came to talk to you and to prophesy to your life. That's what I feel God sent me here for. Are you ready with your notebooks? Now listen to what I'm saying. I've already begun preaching. When God wants to help any man, he releases two major forces in his life. I will repeat it again. When God wants to help a man, he releases two major forces in his life. They are forces. I strongly believe that God wants to help every one of us. And that's why God sent me here today. When God wants to help any man, he releases two major forces. Number one force that he releases is called mercy. God releases mercy. When God wants to help you, he releases what we call mercy. This is my prayer. May God look at you and show you mercy. When God wants to help a man, number one force he releases, Pastor Rotich, is called mercy. Mercy. Hebrews 4:16 says, "Let us come boldly to the throne of grace that we may obtain mercy and grace to help us in time of need." So when God wants to help a man, he releases mercy, number one, as a force. That we may obtain mercy to help us in time of need. Mercy. When God wanted to save us, Pastor Moses, it was mercy that was in operation. I know most of us, the number one thing that comes to your mind is grace, but it is mercy that came first before grace. How do I know? Ephesians chapter 2, verse 4 to 6. Ephesians chapter 2. Verse 4 to 6, the Bible says, "But God, who is rich in what?" Come on, please talk to me. "But God, who is rich in what?" Because of what? Of his great love with which he loved us. Verse number 5, "Even when we were dead in trespasses, he made us alive together with Christ. By grace, you have been saved." Have you seen that? It is mercy that compelled God to love us. Mercy, mercy, mercy. When God wants to help you, when God wants to help me, he releases what we call mercy. Mercy. Let me give you an example, and I will pick it from the Old Testament intentionally. We are saved because of mercy. But let me take the example of Joseph. When Joseph was sold to Egypt in Genesis 39, bought by Potiphar, finally accused falsely and put in prison, the way God helped him, Brother Excellent, is by mercy. Genesis 39, verse 20. Or 21. "But the Lord was with Joseph," verse 21. "And he did what? He showed him what? Mercy." When God wants to help a man, he shows mercy. And this is what God sent me today to do here. That God, I may declare, may God show mercy on every one of us. Mercy. 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 Someone said, if you see a tortoise on a tree, never ask it, "How did you climb a tree?" Because tortoises don't climb on a tree. Somebody must have carried it and put it on top of a tree. That is mercy. Mercy. That is why in life, people don't make it because they are necessarily very hard workers. It is the mercy of God that picks you and singles you out. You are not powerful because of mercy. I'm not a bishop because, I mean you're not powerful because of your energy and strength. No. I'm not a bishop because of my own intellect. No. Mercy. There were many people better than me that God could pick. That is why in the journey of life, what singles people out is the mercies of God. Yani Mungu anakuchukua hivi kwa huruma zake. That's why you cannot explain a man with a PhD is struggling, a person who never went to class is making it in life. It is much. And I want us to make a prayer today. Lord, show me mercy. Lord, show my children mercy. Lord, show my business mercy. Lord, show this church mercy. That is why in the rest of life, according to Paul, Romans 9:16, it is not him that wills or him that runs, Romans 9:16, but whom God shows mercy. Romans 9:16. So then it is not of him who wills, nor of him who runs, but of God who shows mercy. Mungu akikuonyesha huruma, oh God, people will wonder, why are things happening the way they are happening? Why are you making it? Mercy. Mercy. Anytime God wants to help a man, mercy is at work. Mercy is at work. Everyone that came and received a miracle to the Lord Jesus, they begged for mercy. You remember a man who brought his son to the disciples and they could not cast the demon out of him in Mark chapter 9. And then Jesus said, what is happening? He said, I brought my son to the disciples and they could not cast out the demon. Then the man said, Lord, show me mercy. You remember the blind Bartimaeus? He cried out, Lord, show me mercy. Have mercy on me, son of David. That is Mark, the book of Mark. You remember the two blind men who followed Jesus from place to place in Matthew 9. The Bible says they cried, Son of David, show me mercy. Show us mercy. 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 But I like Matthew 15. I like Matthew 15. There is this woman who was a Canaanite woman who came to Jesus and she said, Jesus, heal my daughter. And Jesus said, you cannot take children's bread and cast it to dogs. But she said, Jesus, have mercy on me. And he said, even if I am a dog, show me mercy. Let the dog eat the crumbs that fall out of the master's table. Show me mercy. Jesus said, I've never seen such faith in Israel. Go home. Your daughter is made well. Mercy. 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 My prayer this morning, and I've told you the truth, my intention was not to be here. I'd made up my mind But the Lord commanded that I should be here. Even Reverend Esther said, I feel, go to Kisi. I lift up my hand and I speak mercy. Mercy upon the sick. Mercy upon the poor. Mercy, 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 mercy. Mercy in every marriage. Mercy in every family. Mercy on your head. Mercy on your hands. Mercy on your children. Mercy on your wife. Mercy on your husband. Mercy, mercy on you. Mercy. 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 Please be seated. Mercy.
Mungu akitaka kusaidia mtu ni huruma tu.
How do you explain I came here with a paper bag and this is what we have done? Mercy. There were better preachers here who had bigger churches than I had. Mercy. Mercy. If God can look at you and say, I have mercy on this one, your story is over. Luke 1:54. The man of God said, he has helped Israel, his servant, in remembrance of his what? Amemusaidia Israeli. Kwa sababu amekumbuka huruma, Minister Peter. Mungu akikumbuka tu huruma. There is a prayer that Pastor Esther makes when we pray as a family that touches my heart. She says, Lord, if there is anything good we have ever done, remember mercy and bless us. Mungu kumbuka tu kitu kimoja. Only one. Kama kuna kitu kizuri, Jehovah, tumekufanyia. Ama tumefanya katika huduma. Ama tumefanyia mtu. Bwana kumbuka huruma. I cannot remember the scripture properly. Not that I cannot remember the scripture. I cannot trace it out right now, but it is in my spirit. The Bible says in Psalms that mercy triumphs over judgment. If the media guys will get it, I'll be happy. Mercy has triumphed over judgment. That where there is hata kama umefanya nini, hata kotini, lakini judge akuhurumie, the case is over. For judgment ndio hiyo. It's James, okay, James 2:13. But it's also in Proverbs. I mean Psalms. For judgment is without mercy to the one who has shown no mercy. But mercy triumphs over judgment. That no matter what you have done, mercy will always triumph. Uruma tu. May the Lord have mercy on someone here. Mungu aurumie mtu hapa. Mercy has triumphed over judgment. That any time God wants to help a man, the first thing he releases, mercy. I believe we need to pray, Lord, have mercy upon us. Shall we rise and pray that prayer? I want you to pray on your own language. Please, kila mtu ambaye anataka huruma za Mungu, ili usaidiwe. Inua mikono yako anza kumwambia Bwana akuonyeshe huruma. Just pray. Mercy on your business. Mercy on your family. Mercy on your life. Jamani ongea na Bwana. Bwana, nihurumie uniondoe kwa hii shida. Nihurumie uponye mwili wangu. Nihurumie unibariki. Uniondoe kwa umaskini. Mash. Fungua kinywa chako ongea na Bwana. Let mercy triumph. You have suffered enough. Let the Lord show you mercy. Bwana nionyeshe huruma. Come on, go ahead and talk to Jesus. Mande leke brozia palande. Shalande le brozia palande. Rende leke brozia mpalande zoria. Makateke prozia palata shaya. Reke prozia ndalanka prozia. Ziande moninda la baradozia. Sheleke prozia palande zoria. Mande he brozia talinda la kapala. Shalabala doze londia la barado. If you want the help of God, cry for God's mercy. 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 Go ahead, go ahead. Go ahead and cry, Lord, saidia watoto wangu wameteseka. Bwana nisaidie, nimeteseka, nimeumia. Cry for mercy. Bwana huruma ninaomba. Huruma ninaomba kwa jina la Yesu. Ninaomba huruma. Ninaomba huruma. Ninaomba huruma. Ninaomba huruma Bwana. Let mercy triumph over judgment. Bwana ndio, inawezekana nimekutenda mabaya. Lakini Bwana ninaomba huruma zako zinisaidie. Inawezekana nimekukwaza Mwokozi. Inawezekana nimekuudhi Mwokozi. Lakini huruma zako zinisaidie. Huruma zako zifaulu maishani mwangu. Bwana, nisiendelee mateso haya tena. Naomba huruma Yesu Kristo. Naomba huruma Mwokozi. Naomba huruma Mwokozi. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Lord, let mercy triumph. Let mercy triumph. Let mercy triumph. Show that woman mercy. Lord, wipe our tears. Wipe our tears. Shalande brondila palande. Zaliando brozia palande zoya. Shalande lebrozi ande lekebros. Rande lebrozi palande zori palaha. Shalande lebrozi palande zetoria. Zeke toke plondizala. Mashi. 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 Mashi Jesus. Mercy, Jehovah. Receive help in the name of Jesus. Receive the help of God in the name of Jesus. Receive the help of God. Father, I ask you, show mercy on us. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Shela balado zelendele brozia. Oh God. Oh God. Oh God. Oh God. Oh God. Oh God. Mash. Thank you, Lord. Father, release mercy from your throne. In the name of Jesus. Please be seated. Salama. Salama, 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 nalitaji nalako, naminiweza, salama, 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 salama,
God wants to help a man.
Mercy.
The Bible says in the book of Hebrews, even in the Old Testament, God commanded Moses to build a mercy seat. And the Bible says in heaven, God the Father is seated on the throne of mercy. So God operates from the seat of mercy. It is us men who judge men. But God operates from the seat of mercy. That is why they brought a woman caught in the very act. And Jesus said, I have mercy on this one. Whoever has no sin, because I operate by mercy, let him be the first one. God does not condemn us. God operates by mercy. 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 I think it's 2 Samuel chapter 21. Somewhere there. Where David numbered the children of Israel. And God was very angry. And the people began to die. The soldiers began to die. They were dying. He tried everything. And then a prophet came and said, you have done evil. Choose three things. Choose three things. There will be war in the land. There will be a plague in the land. Or there will be famine in the land. And David said, I don't choose this. Let me fall in the hands of a merciful God. For with God, there is mercy. He said, I refuse to choose all those. Let me fall in the hands of God. For with God, there is mercy. Pamoja na Mungu kuna huruma. Ukingangana kwa siku nyingi, Mungu akuangalie. Aseme nimekuhurumia. Mungangana utaisha. The struggle comes to an end. You are good and your mercy is forever. You are good and your mercy is forever. You are good and your mercy is forever. Jehovah. Jehovah, you are the most high God. May God remember mercy. I know your family might have made sin. I know there might be a generational curse. But may mercy single you out. So that no generational curse will affect you. By mercy. If you read Psalms, you will see David always saying, your mercy. I trust in your mercy. Your mercy. But I think he concluded very well. In Psalm 23 verse 6, he said, surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. May mercy follow you. I may goodness follow you. I stand on this altar and I declare today, may goodness and mercy follow you. I decree and declare in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, may mercy follow you. May mercy follow you. May goodness follow you. May goodness follow your business. May goodness follow your children. May mercy follow your children, your husband, your wife. And everything you touch to do, I declare goodness and mercy follow you. In Jesus Christ's name. Amen. So shall it be.
Number two, when God wants to help a man, he releases grace. When God wants to help a man, he does not only release mercy, he releases what we call grace. Anaachilia neema. Ndio unashangaa watu wanasema maisha ni ngumu. Wewe kwako sio ngumu maana kuna neema imeachiliwa. Others are saying hakuna biashara, but at least you are selling. Kuna neema.
Neema yako, fadhili zako kila asubuhi ni mpya tena zanifariji. Neema yako, fadhili zako kila asubuhi ni mpya tena zanifariji. Baba, utukuzwe, Baba, uinuliwe. Baba, utukuzwe, Baba, uinuliwe. Baba, utukuzwe, Baba, uinuliwe.
When God wants to help a man, he releases grace. Still in Hebrews 4:16, he says, let us therefore come boldly. That word boldly is very important. Unajua watu wengine wanakuja kwa Mungu na wasiwasi as if God will judge them, God will condemn them, God will kill them. Let me say something, but this is not a license for you to sin. No matter what you do, when you come to God, he still remembers mercy. It is not a license for you to do anything. You see a license? At the bishop or me to pay a license. Me, I don't give license to people. But I tell the truth. You know, grace has been misunderstood. But if we read about grace, Titus chapter 2 verse 11. Let us read that one and understand something. But the grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to all men. Titus 2:11. For the grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to how many men? But why are not all men saved? They have not responded to the grace. But let's go. Paul continues to talk about grace in verse number 12. What does it say? The grace is teaching us that denying ungodliness. Ungodliness is sin. Is worldly lust. That we should live soberly. You are not confused. Hata kuku inajua nyumbani. So when you are under grace, you cannot be confused. Unaenda kwa mwanamke ambao sio wako. Ama kwa mume ambao sio wako. You are sober. Unajua kwako ni wapi. That we should live soberly, righteously, and godly. When? Present. Nsai. Hii kusema hakuna mtu mtakatifu hapana. Neema inakuwezesha kukaa na akili timamu. You can make the correct decisions. You can live righteously and godly in this present age. Na tena hapa kishi. Sio binguni, wapi? Sinikikuja hapa naishi peke yangu. Sineza jifungia kwa nyumba. Na niweke msichana hapo. Na nimuambie, tukimalizana utoke saa 6 ya usiku. So that mchana natoka tu nikiwa mtakatifu. Hakuna mtu anajua. Lakini si Mungu anajua. Anaona.
Now, I did not define mercy, but let me define grace. Grace is God's ability. Unajua watu wajaelewa neema ni nini? It is a divine ability, is a divine enablement, is divine empowerment. Ni uweza wa Mungu. Grace is divine ability, enablement, unawezeshwa. Minister Wanjala, you are not able, but God enables you. Yani unajua hiki tusiwezi, hii nilifanya ni Mungu. Wachungaji wakikuja hapo wananiuliza ulijenga aje, ulitoa wapi pesa? Kuna mzungu, naambia hata mimi sijui. By the way, zile pesa mlitoa tukijenga hizi kwa wale walikuwa. Comparing now na waitishaga, mko wakavu this time. Lakini neema imeachiliwa. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Neema imefanya nini? Imeachiliwa. I cannot tell. Nakumbuka ningekuwa nawaambia jamani, tunahitaji 3.5 million ya kuleta viti. Mnanipea. Zinakuja tu. Sasa hivi nawaambia tulete 100 ya parking. 100 na 3.5. 100 na 3.5. Kulikuwa na neema. Na naomba Mungu aachilie hiyo neema tena. May the Lord release that grace again. Na by the way, tumerudishiwa parking kama hamuna habari. Kwa hivyo kuanzia Sunday unarudi unapark. Sema neema. Mtu ashout tena neema. Hata parking inaendelea. Sema neema. Aha. Grace is an ability. Grace is an enablement. Let me give you a scripture. Unajua mimi nasomaga Bible. Mimi nasomaga Bible kuliko vitabu za watu. I read books, but I read the Bible most. Now, the Bible says, for sin, Romans 6:14, sin shall not have dominion over you. For you are not under the law, but under grace. You are under an ability, an enablement. Sin can have dominion. Dhambi ina nguvu. Dhambi ina nguvu. Dhambi ina nguvu. Ndio kwa sababu watu wengine wameshindwa kuacha dhambi. Maana ina nguvu, inakuvuruta. But when you come to the grace, divine enablement, divine ability, unashangaa niliacha pombe namna gani? Sina kiu ya pombe tena, sina tamaa ya pombe tena, iliendaje? There was a divine ability. And that is called grace. So when sema umepokea neema na bado unaendelea kwa dhambi, neema inakufundisha kukaa vizuri. Hatunajua mimi naishi kwa neema na neema inafanya it doesn't matter. Usisikiliza wahubiri wa YouTube. Sikiliza pastor yule Mungu amekupea. Wacha nirudie tena. Wacha kusikiliza wahubiri wa YouTube. Jeremiah 3:15 inasema namna gani? For I will give you pastors according to my own heart, who shall teach you knowledge and understanding. Wao watakufundisha maarifa na ufahamu. Yule mchungaji Mungu anakupea ndiye atakufundisha ufahamu. Sio wa YouTube. Your pastor is not a YouTube pastor. Na kuna wahubiri wengi wa YouTube wanafundisha neema, neema. God has taken care of our past sin, our present sin, and the future sin because you are under. Kwa hivyo unatenda dhambi ukijua future sin is taken care of. Ukipokea neema, sin shall not have dominion over you because you have divine enablement. Divine ability. Mungu akisaka kusaidia mtu anaachilia neema. Neema kubwa. Na hiyo pia ndio nataka kutangaza hapa leo. Mungu aachilie neema. Paul had a problem in 1 Corinthians 12 and he cried to God. The Bible says he had a thorn in the flesh. From verse 7, 1 Corinthians 12, from verse number 7. He said, I had a thorn in the flesh. Nilikuwa na shida. Nilikuwa na tatizo. Nikamulilia Mungu mara tatu, nisaidie, nisaidie. Mungu akasema, nimeachilia neema. My grace is sufficient. Na nitakusaidia kwa neema. Na utatoboa katika hili jambo. Utatoka. And he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you. And my strength shall be made perfect. Unaona? Unaona neema inaachilia strength in weakness. Divine ability. Uwezo wa Mungu. So when God wants to help you, number one, he releases mercy. Number two, he releases grace. Anaachilia neema tofauti. That is the reason why tunaitwa kanisa ya Illuminati. Ati watu wakienda hiyo kanisa wananunua magari. Mukiona ma message niko nazo hapa kwa simu. Na baada mjanunua. Nasema mjanunua. Mutanunua matraki ya kupeleka Tanzania mizigo na Uganda na wapi. Bado amujanunua. Amujanunua. Na nyinyi na mjenge ma apartments, wacheni mchezo. Maana naachilia neema. Naachilia neema. Naachilia neema kwa kazi yako, kwa biashara yako. Pokea neema kwa jina la Yesu. Pokea neema. Pokea. Pokea. Paul cried and he said, Lord, how do I come out of this problem? God says, I release grace. And my strength shall be seen in the challenge that you are going through. Naachilia neema. Naachilia neema. This is our month of grace. I want to talk to you about what Paul calls this grace. 2 Corinthians 8, verse number 7. This grace. This grace. This grace. But as you abound in everything, your faith in speech, knowledge, diligence, love for us, but see that you abide in this grace also. Kuna neema fulani. Paulo anawaambia, mumejaa imani. Neno na usemi mumejaa na. Maarifa ya Mungu mko nayo. Bidii mko nayo. Upendo mko nayo. But this grace is what is lacking in them. Which grace is that? Go to verse number 1. 2 Corinthians 8, verse number 1. Which grace is this? Moreover, brethren, we make known to you the grace of God bestowed on the Macedonian church. Nataka mfahamu hii neema. Kiswahili inasema hivyo. Iliyoachiliwa juu ya makanisa ya Macedonia. Haikuwa kanisa moja, makanisa mengi. Ndio kwa sababu haupaswi kufikiria Deliverance Church is the only church. Tena ndugu zetu, tuwaarifu habari ya neema ya Mungu waliopewa. Naomba Mungu awapatie iyo neema. Mungu afanye nini? Awapatie. May God give you this grace. Nataka mufahamu hii neema. Give me verse 2 in English. This is the grace. That in great trial of affliction. Nataka uangalie neema inawatoa kwa mateso. Abundance of their joy. Their deep poverty abounded in the riches of their liberality or generosity.
Kwamba walikuwa wamezama. They were in deep poverty and affliction, but they had joy. But because of this grace, they began to prosper. Walikuwa ndani, Biblia inaita, hii ni tofauti. Pastor Rotich, it's called, sio poverty. Deep. It is not poverty. It is deep. They received a particular grace God gave them. Na furahia, sio mwanadamu anapeana hii. Ni Mungu anapeana hii neema. Na ninaomba hiyo neema ishuke kwa kila mmoja wetu.
Kila mmoja wetu. Kila mmoja wetu. Hii neema hii ni ya kuondoa watu kwa umasikini. Verse 3, tusome.
For I bear witness that according to their ability, yes, and beyond, they were freely willing. Number 4, what does it say? Imploring us with much urgency that we would receive a gift or an offering and the fellowship of ministering to the saints. Continue. And not only as we had hoped, but they first gave themselves to the Lord, then they gave to us by the will of God. How do you connect to this grace? Number 1, you give yourself to God. What did they do? They gave themselves to God. Walijipeana kwa Mungu. Hawakujipeana tu kwa kanisa. They gave themselves. We are living in a generation. So many people have not given themselves to God seriously. Sometimes I see, once in a while, I go through Facebook to see what is going on, meetings, and then sometimes I see funny articles. I do. Many people will go for baby showers, dress very smart. But the same people, if you invite them for prayers, they will not come. Because many people nowadays have given themselves to the things of pleasure, the things of the world, but they have not given themselves to God. Wapendwa, nimerudia hii mara nyingi hii mwaka, lakini naomba mshike. I pray above all, please give yourself to God. Tafadhali jipeane kwa Mungu. Usalama wako uko kwa Mungu. Utajiri wako uko kwa Mungu. Msaada wako uko kwa Mungu. Baraka yako iko kwa Mungu. Paul is saying to the Corinthian church, kuna neema that was on the Macedonian churches. Haikuwa kanisa moja, ilikuwa mingi, zilizokuwa Macedonia. Ni kama kusema, neema iliyo katika makanisa ya Kisii. Okay? The churches in Kisii. Neema. Anaambia wa Korintho, nataka mpokee. Hawa watu walikuwa na mateso, affliction, and deep poverty. Lakini wakapokea neema. Na wakatajirika. Number 2. Number 1, they gave themselves to the Lord. Number 2, they gave offerings willingly by the will of God. By the will of God. By the will of God. By the will of God.
they gave themselves to God and they gave. Verse number 3 and 5 says the same thing. Not only as we had hoped, but they first gave themselves to the Lord, then to us by the will of God. They gave. And number 3, they gave themselves to the men of God. Na hiyo sasa hapo ndio ujinga iko kwa Wakristo wengi. Usijipeane tu kwa mtumishi wa Mungu to manipulate you. Sijui kama mmeelewa? Hapo kuna ujinga, hapo ndio shakaola inaanzia. Mtu anawaambia uza mali yako yote ulete hapa. Yesu wako karibu kurudi. Paul said to the Corinthian church, if you need the help to come out of your affliction, to come out of deep poverty, 3 things are very important. Number 1, give yourself to God. Number 2, give offerings by the will of God. This they did by the will of God. Verse number 5. Ebu iweke hapo. Nataka uone hiyo. By the will of God. Sio mapenzi ya manadamu. This, they first gave themselves to, then to us by the will of God. Kwa mapenzi ya Mungu. Sio mapenzi ya mwanadamu. And then verse 3 says, we bear record. And beyond their ability, they were freely willing. They were not forced. Awakulazimishwa. Hey, kuja maombi. Kuja maombi. No. They were not forced to read the Bible. No. They were not forced even to give their tithes and their offerings. They were not forced on anything. Everything they did, they gave themselves to God. If you read the Bible, Paul never wanted to take an offering from them. Akutaka. Aliwaangalia akaona watu sitaki kuchukua sadaka. Lakini wao wenyewe they entreated him, they begged him. Verse 3 ndio hiyo verse number 4, imploring us. King James version inasema entreating us. Please receive. And then God made them rich. Let's go to 2 Corinthians chapter number 9. Verse number 6. But I say, Paul anaendelea kuwafundisha from verse 8, chapter 8, anasema, but I say, he who sows sparingly will also reap sparingly. He who sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. Iyo, it goes without saying, ukipanda shamba eka moja, na mwingine apande 50 by 100, mavuno ni tofauti. Sinikweli. That one goes without saying. I don't need to explain much. But let's go to verse number, the next verse, number 7. And that's what I want you to get. So let each one of us give as he purposes in his heart. Not grudgingly or of necessity. You are being forced. For God loves a cheerful giver. That is not where I was heading. I was heading to verse number 9. But that is very important. Verse number 8. Sorry. And God is able to make all grace abound toward you. Why? That you always, having all sufficiency in all things, may have an abundance for every good work. Yani Mungu anawezo kuachilia hiyo neema. Mukijitolea kwa Mungu. Patia Mungu maisha yako. Believe in your prophet. That's the right word. Though ijatumika hapo, Paul anasema they gave themselves to us. But it is belief in your man of God. But another thing is they gave offerings willingly. They were not forced. As a man purposes in his heart. Paul anawaambia, mukifanya hivyo, God is able.
What does it say? To Psalm 1-3. God is what? God is what? To do what? So that you may have all sufficiency. In other words, God will make sure you don't lack. You are sufficient. Finances are released. Help is released. Everything, in all things. And not only that, for every good work. That's why unaweza saidia yatima, unaweza bariki mjane, unaweza na mtu maskini ukamnunulia kiatu. Maana Bwana ameachilia neema inaoachilia vitu vyote katika maisha yako, na sio ya kwako peke yako, lakini ya kukusaidia wewe na ya ziada, ya ziada. Yeah. Ya ziada ya kusema Mungu asante umenibariki, sitakula peke yangu. Kuna mtoto yatima pale, nitakula na yeye. Kuna wa children's home, nitakula na wao. Kuna jirani yangu hapa maskini, ataonja kile niko. Paulo anawaambia, tafadhali, hata kama muna neema, Weka hiyo verse number, 1 Corinthians. Let's go to verse number, 1 Corinthians. I mean 2 Corinthians 8, verse number 7. He says, as much as you abound in faith, in knowledge, in speech, in all diligence, and in love for us, make sure, don't miss this grace. Musikose hii neema iliyokuwa juu ya makanisa ya Macedonia. Walikuwa katika mateso, affliction, umasikini mbaya, lakini wakatajirika kwa sababu ya hiyo neema ambao Mungu aliachilia. Na walifanya mambo matatu. Wakajitoa kwa Bwana, sio kwa kanisa. Kanisa ni nzuri, lakini kwanza jipatiane kwa Bwana. Na shukuru kwa wote mliofika hapa, lakini kama hujatupatiana kwa Bwana, unapoteza wakati. Jipatiane kwa number one. Hata hivi vitu viwili vingine ni vya muhimu, lakini sio vya muhimu kama kujipatiana. Bwana ndiye msaada wetu. Na unajua Paulo alikuwa hadanganyi. Maana Paulo alimuogopa Mungu, maana alitaka kufika mbinguni. Paulo alimuogopa Mungu sana. Hakuwahubiria kama vile tunawahubiria siku hizi sisi wahubiri, including myself. Na kuhubiria na lengo ya kukutoanisha. Alikuwa anataka wafundishe, wapokee neema ya Mungu. Maana kile Mungu anatoa ni permanent. Kile mwanadamu anakupatia ni cha muda. Second Corinthians chapter 4. Hebu tusikie vile Paulo alisema, namalizia sasa hivi. Ndawapatia maandiko mengine mawili nitamalizia. Alisema therefore, verse 1. Therefore, seeing we have this ministry that we have received from the Lord. As we have received what? Angalia hiyo tena. Therefore, since we have this ministry, as we have received what? Mercy. We do not faint. Verse 2. Angalia hii. Anashemaje. But we have renounced hidden things of shame. Not walking in craftiness. Not handling the word of God deceitfully. But by the manifestation of truth. Commending ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of God. Kwa nawaambia wa Korintho. Siwafundishi mambo ya uongo. Namuogopa Mungu. Nimekataa dhambi za siri. Na atutaki ujanja wa neno. Handling the word of God deceitfully. Iyo ni chapter 4. Ndiyo anakuja chapter number 8. Naambia yote nao wafundisha ni ya kweli. Na mnajua Paulo alikataa kusema ni yeye. Lakini anasema ninamfahamu mtu alienda katika bingu ya tatu. Akaongea na Bwana, na yale mambo Mungu aliyomwambia hayawezi akayasema.
hakutaka kusema ni mimi. Kwa kuna mambo aliyoyasikia ambaye anayaandika hapa. Paulo alitaka kufika binguni. Anaambia Wagalatia namna hii. I want to prove what he is writing. That anasema kuna neema ya utajiri. Kuna neema. Galatians 1:20. Alisema hivi, Minister Moses, now the things which I write to you, behold, before God, I lie not. Siwadanganyi. Haya mambo nawaandikia ni ya kweli. Haya mambo ninayowaambia ni ya kweli. Romans 9:1 tena karudia. Akasema hivi, I say the truth in Christ. Ni kama na hapa. I say the truth. I lie not. Siwadanganyi. My conscience is also bearing witness in the Holy Ghost. I tell the truth in Christ. I am not lying. My conscience is also bearing me witness together with the Holy Spirit. Siwadanganyi. Wakorintho ninayowaambia ni kweli. Kuna neema ya utajiri na unaipata hii neema kwa vitu vitatu. Na yeye ametuelezea hapo. Jitolee kwa Bwana. Amini wachungaji wako. Toa sadaka zako. Fungo lako la kumi. Na Paulo akasema, tafadhali, ninaomba msikose hii neema. Abide. Let it abound. The Greek, the Hebrew word for the word abound ni kumaanisha to continue, to stay, to remain. Naomba mbakie kwa hii neema. Kwamba ukishaingia kwa hii neema inakutoa kwa shida, inakutoa kwa umaskini. Musitoke kwa hiyo neema tena. Mubaki kwa hiyo neema. Muendelee kuwa matajiri siku zote. Muendelee kuwa na mfaida siku zote. Muendelee kupata msaada siku zote. Kaeni kwa hii neema. Nami nasimama kwa madhabahu haya nasema hivi, Mungu aachilie hiyo neema. Tusimame katika miguu yetu. May the Lord release that grace in your life. May that grace be upon your life. Come on, say a better amen. May the grace of God take away affliction from your life. May the grace of God take you from deep poverty. May the grace of God cause you to swim in riches for yourself, for your children, and for the orphans and the less fortunate. Naomba Mungu awabariki zaidi mbariki wengine. Naomba kanisa hili libarikiwe. Mwe matajiri. Mubariki mpaka majirani. Mubariki mayatima. Mubariki. Yehova awabariki na neema hiyo. Pokea hiyo neema kwa jina la Yesu. Wakati Mungu anataka kumsaidia mtu, mambo mawili. Huruma. Kwa neema ndio fadhili ama ni nini? Hapana, yani masi. Masi ni fadhili. Si ndio? Ni neema. Ni rehema. Mungu aachilie juu katika maisha yako. Amen. Amen. Mama Rua, ulio la umiyuzi. Okay. Zamani kuna uniliita mhubiri. Akatolea Mama Rua sasa prophecy, akamwambia wewe weka digiri zako pamoja. Tumi Mama Rua kama unakumbuka. Kwa maana Mungu anaenda kukupatia kazi kwa county. I've never forgotten. Mama Rua akakuja baadaye akaniambia, pastor, hata primary sikumaliza. Lakini neema ya Mungu imemsaidia. Neema. So unakumbukaga hiyo? Kutoka siku hiyo sijaiita huyo mhubiri. Sasa unadanganya. Mungu amekuambia. Huyu Mungu ajui mtu hakumaliza primary. Lift your hands to heaven. Omba neema na neema, mercy and grace.
mercy and grace. Bwana nisaidie. Shalapalato sekotori handeleke brozia. Mandeleke brozi palinda la baladoji. Mandele brozia ta palatesia. Mandele hembrozi palante zelete de broz. Mandele brozi handeleke broz. Shalapaladoze lendele brozi handa. Mandele brozi handele kebrozia. Mandele brozi landele kambra zete le kebrozi. Mandele kebrozi tala kapalado. Shela baladoze londi la baladoze. Randele kebrozi da la baladoze. Mandele kebrozi tala baladoze. Mandele brozi handele kebrozia. Mandele kebrozi tala baladoze. Oh God, mercy and grace. Mandele brozi tala baladoze. Randele brozi handele broz. Mercy and grace. Mercy and grace, Jesus. Mercy and grace. Woo! Mercy and grace. Oh God, release mercy and grace. Mercy and grace. Mercy and grace. Mercy and grace. Oh Lord, mercy and grace. Come on, pray. Receive mercy, receive grace. That is why I came today. That is why God sent me here. God sent me here for you. Shalom baladozi lori andeleke bros. Oh Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you. Mandele kembrosia talam baradosia. Shalandele kembrosi palande. Oh Jesus. Mandele kembrosia talam baradosia. Mandele kembrosi palande zoriande. Jesus, I thank you. Mandele kebrozia. Lift your hands to heaven. Father, I am here by divine appointment. Father, you know the whole truth that I was not meant to be here today, but you commanded me to come. In the name of Jesus, I just came to declare, let mercy rest on everyone's head. Amen. Mercy rest on everyone's home. Amen. Let your mercy rest and let there be help on everyone. Amen. Father, I pray, let the grace of God rest on each one's head. Lord, let each one of us come from any form of affliction by grace. By your grace. By your grace. Sickness affliction. Poverty affliction. Affliction of any nature. Oh God, release grace on our children. On our spouses. On our works. On our businesses. In our place of work. I speak mercy and grace in the name of Jesus Christ. And we all said,
amen.
Receive your healing, receive your deliverance, receive your lifting.
Hallelujah.
Before I forget, let me say two things that I hear from the Lord. There are some of us that God has helped so much. That's what I hear. But you came to a place, you became so reluctant, and you stopped serving God in prayers and in your finances. I hear two things. God says, return. And as I'm speaking to you, you know yourself, and you know it is God speaking to you. Mungu amekusaidia sana, but you stopped. God says, return. The second word I have is the word I had for Pastor Rotich when I spoke about his promotion, and he was not thinking about it. I have a word. Omonyo, I have a word for you. I want to speak that God will open a door of favor. But I will need to talk to you after the service. But the Lord will grant you a job that will turn around your captivity.
Neema yako, fadhili zako kila asubuhi.
Received Jesus as your Lord and Savior. If you want this mercy to operate in your life, give your life, receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior. So if wherever you are, come. If you have never received Jesus as your Lord and Savior, I want to pray with you. Come. And I will not beg you. Number two, I feel in my spirit there is someone that God had graced you. Things were going well, but they started going bad, and that made you backslide. God says in my spirit, that was I hear deep within in my spirit, that if you come back to Christ, He will restore the grace back to you. Want to receive Jesus? You had received Christ and you backslid and things began to go bad. There is the grace of restoration. Things will go well again. If you are the one, come. I want to pray with you. If you don't come, I have no problem. What God sent me to do in Kisi today, I have done. I'm waiting for you. I give you a minute. Come. Kama hujaokoka ungependa kumpokea Yesu njoo. I said, if you come, it is well. If you feel embarrassed, for this one in particular who feels you had backslidden, you are feeling very embarrassed. That's what I'm hearing. How can I go forward? What will people think? Is it about what people are thinking, or is it about you and God? What do you think? That's what I feel to ask you. If you don't come, I'm closing. I
I'm done. Let me pray for the sick. Father, I release the grace and mercy for healing in the name of Jesus. I bless every child of God here. I release blessing. Let the captivity of your people turn around. Let blessings locate each one of us. In Jesus' name we pray, and we all said,
amen.